Hey guys, what's up? Today I will show you tracking an object into 3D using After Effects and then exporting to 3ds Max for further editing. So first of all, subscribe to Specdemon for tutorials and VFX and press that bell icon. Also don't forget to like the video. Okay, so first of all, pick an object and wrap it in a green colored paper or a cloth. Size and shape of object should be related to the 3D object that you will insert later. Now draw some dots on its surface that will be used to track its position. And now you will record the video with the object visible in the shot. Don't get anything in front of the object unnecessarily. After recording the video, open After Effects. Okay, so here we go. First of all, I will import the actual footage. Drag it down to make composition. So, why I use the green object here? The reason is that with this I can hide other parts of video and track specifically the green object. Okay, now select key light and select the object then. Select the alpha view from there. Now you have to change those two parameters to make the object black and others white. Okay, that's better. Turn back to RGB view. Now we have the object transparent. But we will invert the alpha. Duplicate that layer. Okay, now from here we will make the alpha inverted. And turn off the effects on second layer. That's it, the object is visible. And other world is not. Okay, now the markers on the object are also invisible. So we have to bring them back. For that, do this. That's it. Pre-compose these two layers. Still, we have to mask the parts those are still visible. Create masks around that object. Set all on subtract. And now just track camera for the pre-composed layer. Wait for this. If it fails, try another tracking method. And now it is successful. Now you can turn off all the effects and masks. That's it. Let's insert any solid to check. Select any three minimum markers and right-click. That's the 3D solid inserted. Okay, for further working with 3D. We will export it to 3ds Max. Now to export it to 3ds Max. Delete the solid and camera as well. Select some markers. Make sure to set them as ground plane and origin. And now create nulls and camera. Select all the nulls and camera. You can see that the axis is well aligned with the object. Now for exporting to 3ds Max, you have to download the script file. The link is in the description. It's just a file that you have to paste in the scripts folder. Instructions given in the link. After you do that, this option will be available in your After Effects. This sets the world scale for the export. And it's exported to desktop. Now close it and open 3ds Max. Here you have to run that script which was exported from After Effects. Here is the camera and those null objects that were exported. These will be rotated 90 degrees anti-clock from left view. Select all, then group them, and rotate clockwise by 90 degrees. Position those green dummies on the center. Okay, you will be wondering, that instead of the object the camera is moving. So that will not cause big issues, and the results will be same, and according to the laws of motion, this is relatively correct. However, if I insert objects in the scene those were static in real shot, I will attach them to the camera. Now let's set the background. Select that actual footage. There it is. The grid is aligned with the object. Insert objects that you would like for your project. You can see that object is replaced with a CGI object. So that's it guys. Thanks for watching, and like the video. And subscribe to Spectamin for more tutorials and VFX.